What's up, Nate? Thank you for the subscription. Yo, yo, yo. Good day. Hello, everyone. Sorry for not being around on Wednesday. Made sure to have all fawns in the moving stream. Right behind me. How's everyone doing today? The alpaca is actually a llama, as it turns out. I named him Alphonse the alpaca, well, because of the matching A's initially, but then it turned out that he's just a llama. Let's see, doing so good. Glad to hear that, Mike. I was just in the middle of listening to Earthbound OST. Nice. I'm not familiar with Earthbound. Assuming it's a game? Or is it a movie? Sounds like it's a game. Just a llama. Yeah. Well, you know what I mean. I had a dinner yesterday with my mom and my girlfriend. The same thing happened. Oh yeah, so she brought over a plant as a gift to my mom, which was really nice of her. And I thought she brought something else too. Like she had brought a bottle of wine too or something along those lines. And then so I said, oh, you didn't bring a wine bottle, you just brought the plant. And then my mom and her looked at me like, how rude. She comes with a gift and this is how you thank her. But yeah, definitely not what I meant. Well, how would you phrase that? I only brought the plant, or you only brought the plant. That still sounds like I'm blaming her for not bringing wine at that point. Sad girlfriend noises. Llamas came up in conversation? No, not quite. Not quite. Anyways, so for today's stream, not entirely sure what to do here. This is going to be my last time streaming. Yo, wise guy, thank you for the sub. Much appreciated.
Hey.
Hey, back at you. So this is my first or last time streaming out of this room. So I'm hoping, fingers crossed, that starting next week, I can stream out of my new apartment. So I'm moving in there tomorrow, and I don't know, from my experience, sometimes it can be difficult to have everything, like internet-wise, good to go. Very, like right off the bat, got my fingers crossed. I'm hoping that'll be fine. And if that's the case, next week will be pretty awesome, because I'm working with the design team that is part of my the company that manages me, and we've been they've been developing some new emotes with me for the Twitch streams, and we're gonna be doing some other improvements as well. But yeah, so I guess today is mostly just to kind of say hi, and hang out, talk, jam, do some feedback, because it's Friday. Noodle merch? I mean, noodle emotes, I can't confirm or deny noodle emotes. I don't know, what do you think? What does this face tell you? Is there gonna be a noodle emote? I haven't really just relaxed and played much piano today. I've been packing stuff up like crazy. You probably can't tell from this room, because it's not really looking much different. I only had my studio stuff down here, which is I purposely left this stuff here so I could do one last stream before I head out. I've moved a decent amount in my lifetime, probably more than your average 27-year-old, I'd say. Because even as a kid, I moved around a lot, but that somehow didn't make me good at moving. But by now, I think in the last 5 years, I've moved more than once a year, actually, at this point. So I moved once a year, and then I guess in total, I will have moved 6 times in the last 5 years or so, which I suspect is probably a bit more than average. And then before that, in my childhood, I moved a decent amount too. But yeah, at least by now, I've learned a few tricks. Making sure you don't just throw stuff into random cardboard boxes the day before.
I can remember.
Yo, Kark Tank.
For the music.
Thank you so much for that. For that cheer. Wait, was that a cheer? I think so. And I'm really happy to hear that. My music has been an inspiration to you. I mean, it really does mean a lot to me. I think sometimes. I'm not sure why, but sometimes I try not to think about that too much. It genuinely gets a little scary once you realize that, I don't know, there are people out there listening to your stuff and engaging with it. I mean, obviously it's a positive thing that you're inspired by what I'm doing, but yeah, regardless, thank you. Thank you. through gust. Thank you for the tier 2 sub. You might be the only one. I think there's one tier 3 sub, zero tier 2s, and everyone else is tier 1, I think. So starting next week, there is going to be, I think pretty much for the first time ever, there are going to be exclusive emotes for the different tiers too, which is going to be cool. So, question for you guys. To all the musicians, producers that are currently in the stream. I've been working on a sample pack, and I kind of decided recently exactly what direction I want to take with it. And I was kind of curious what kind of chord progressions you guys might have interest in, if you were to imagine, chord progressions that you've heard of mine. Would you want to have access to stuff that's like, in terms of MIDI stuff, that's more on the complex end, like really crazy jazzy chords, or just anything and everything? Or is there anything particular that you guys would want? Something that has no triads at all. It's funny that you say that, because I don't think as of right now I have any triads in any of the chord progressions that are in there. Like, triads, you can only, I think, effectively use triads in like pop music. I guess there's probably quite a few different types of music, but I don't know, triads are just so boring to me. Maybe in scores. Like, there's a lot of probably scores that make really good use of triads. Yeah, I mean, I guess a lot of the time simpler is better, so ain't nothing wrong with triads. Triads as an overlay of extensions for a different key. If you're talking about having, are you saying like stacking triads on top of each other? Because that's kind of like just extensions, really. Can you play Lingus? Oh, yo. Thank you for the cheer, anonymous cheer. Wait, what? An anonymous cheer cheered. Like C and B flat with a D major triad on top. Yeah, totally. I would just consider that a polytonal chord. But yeah, it was kind of tough when I started working on the sample pack. I wasn't sure I was trying to figure out what people would want in it. But I kind of figured out after some time of working on like what I wanted to do with it. Because I think a lot of sample packs are geared towards like, well, every sample pack has some kind of theme. And I think a lot of times it's geared towards maybe like an artist's style or their strengths and stuff, like very intentionally. And I think what I ended up wanting to do with it was just create things that I find inspiring, so that other artists can use those as like the foundation for their own ideas and stuff. So I ended up creating like a really wide variety of random things. Little phrases and loops and obviously like one shots and kind of like the typical stuff too, But yeah, kind of like building blocks for being able to make your own music out of it. Sounds like a saying goodbye song or something. Why don't we do this? Why don't you guys give me some ideas on things to try to score, and I'll try to do my best to write music that matches the mood of what you guys are suggesting. They'll help me get warmed up creatively. A breakup. I mean, that's the perfect kind of song to use triads for, I feel like. That actually scared me. Holy crap. A breakup in 5/4.
Awesome music.
when two music theory nerds break up, the music does have to be in an odd time signature, doesn't it? Thank you for listening to it, whoever donated just now. So let's try that in 5/4. Too fast to be a breakup. I don't know. Let's see what else there is in the comments. A breakup in a swing tempo. I don't know. That sounds so goofy to me. Like, why? I don't know. Sounds too upbeat. Like, that sounds like it would clash with a really emotional chord progression. Like, I don't know. That just completely ruins the breakup mood. What's snake jazz? Dude in 7-Eleven? Jesus. Someone's slipping on a banana peel. I don't know. It's a pretty short song. I actually heard about the 7-Eleven challenge. Dude at the 7-Eleven star? Hey, thank you for the cheered Kark Tank. A Mario Kart level? I never actually played Mario Kart, but everyone knows the... Could do like a jazzified version of a... What if there's like a... Is there a like a jazzy like lounge type of vibe at any point in the Mario games? Thank you. Dire Dire Docks? Plant music. I'm not really sure. Half of these I'm not sure what to make of, to be honest. Underwater level, yeah, I know that's a famous one too. Let's see. Let me read through the comments and see if there's anything else. Reharmonized Mario. That sounds kind of fun. I wish I actually knew the song well enough
Jesse
to do that.
Jazzy Howl of the Mountain Kind.
Jazzy Howl of the Mountain King? Well, that one's pretty easy, I feel like. But that's not really a mood or a vibe, but I can still do it. September by Earth, Wind, and Fire in a minor key. Isn't that a minor key? Exactly what the chord progression is for that, actually, but it's so iconic.
Can you play Lingus by Snarky Puppy?
Can I play Lingus by Snarky Puppy? I cannot, but it's a beautiful piece. I could probably play along with it. It's just one. It's one of those songs that like has blown me away, but it's also 7 minutes long. And I, yeah, I didn't spend the time learning that one. It'd be pretty cool though to learn that solo that a million people have subscribed by transcribed from Corey Henry. Guy's an absolute legend. Hey, never thought I would see the day when I got to watch Haywyre live. Hey, welcome to the stream, man. Today's not a particularly special one, but I hope it entertains you nonetheless. Flight of the Bumblebee. Man. I never learned that one either, but it's just chromatic stuff, so maybe I can do it. Or maybe I can swing it. I don't know. I don't know. That one's not really clicking. Ugh. I sat down and actually learned it, then I'm not quite that proficient. Crane Moving Piano Cover. Ooh. That is such a cool song. Hold on. It's like pretty much my favorite song of his, I believe. I do believe so. Let's find it. Such a fun tune. Let's see what else is on here. Other suggestions. That American came out of nowhere. I'm just reading all these comments out of totally out of context. Flight of the Murder Hornet. Jesus. It'd basically just be the same thing as the Flight of the Bumblebee, but every single note would have a minor triad following it. Ugh, that'd be so hard to play. Seinfeld theme? I mean, I kind of know how to fake it. Play your favorite OST. Oh, man. I haven't really been digging into movie OSTs that much lately. Whenever I think of OSTs, I always think of, like, generic stuff that I already know how to play. Like, there's probably a lot of OSTs that I think are amazing, but I don't know how to play. I am a sucker for John Williams and Hans Zimmer, as generic as those names are, in the, like, scoring world, but yeah, I'm definitely a fan of both of those guys. But there's a lot of other people that have written some incredible scores out there. Yamaha synth over there. It's a pretty sweet little thing. a noodle, Harry. I love it. Any Deadmau5 song? Oh man, that'd be a fun one to play along with. Have you tried Keyscape for Spectrasonics? That is indeed what I'm using currently. Put some swing in the Hedwig's theme. Hell yeah. We got. I'm having fun with this strobe. Oh my god, everyone wants strobe in here. Jesus. I don't that wasn't, sorry, I didn't mean that in an offensive way. I swear to god, like, I can't tell sometimes whether to never mind. Okay, let's pull up strobe. Like, am I being too nice if I apologize for saying things that can be misunderstood? People apologize for that stuff, right? Oh my god, 50 million views? Are you kidding me? Trying to figure out what the hell's going on with this chord progression. Cool intro. Hey, when's the last time you guys listened to this song? Like, it's, the spacing of the phrasing is so long that sometimes it feels like a guessing game. I mean, I think I'd actually have to, like, listen to the song again and play from the beginning. I remember when the song came out, though, and it was, like, just such an incredibly badass tune.
Ich versuche einen DNB-Track zu remixen. Hast du Tipps für mich?
Yo, Nimic360, thanks for the sub. Tipps für dich, für einen DNB-Track zu remixen? Schwer zu sagen, ich meine, ich schreibe selbst nicht viel Drum and Bass. Ich glaube, ich habe vielleicht einmal Drum and Bass produziert unter dem Namen Haywyre und überhaupt in generell. Aber ich würde sagen, vielleicht, warte mal, ich muss das in Englisch sagen. Ich mein Deutsch ist leider nicht so gut. I would say reference, find reference tracks. That would be a good place to start. There's tons of incredible drum and bass out there. So I would say make sure you're referencing drum and bass that you think is good, and being aware of that when you're making your remix. And good luck. Do you like drum and bass? Yeah, drum and bass is super fun, I think. It's weird that it's not bigger in the US. It's much bigger in Europe than it is here, but I like it. I don't really grow up with it, though. It's just, I don't know, it just never got as big here, and since I've spent most of my life in North America, I just never really got that exposed to it. All right, guys. You guys want, like, one more suggestion before we go into feedback? If you want me to score a feeling or play along to something... I can try to play along or something that I don't know. Kind of felt like that's what I was just doing with Strobe. Didn't realize how long it's been since I've listened to that song. Carpenter Brett. That could be fun. Oh my god, Grammatic Can't Stop the Bleeding is such a good song. Heart and Soul and Ultimate Jazz. Queen would be fun. What's that, Bite the Dust? How does that song go again? Well, obviously Bohemian Rhapsody is kind of like their staple song. They have so many successful songs, but that one would be a lot of fun to play along with. Another One Bites the Dust. Oh, yeah. It's so interesting how many bass lines, like, especially, like, more disco-y bass lines start like that. Like, there's also the, is it the Rapper's Delight that goes like... ¶¶ That's the one. Just looking in the comments to see if there's anything else. Hang Glide is an incredible track. I love that tune. Oh, hey, you should do a remix of Young and Alive. I bet nobody that listens to my music figured a Bazzy remix was coming out this year. How about something from Madian's album? That could be cool. Thomas the Tank engine theme, but jazzified. Boom, 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 dun, dun. How does that... I never watched Thomas the Tank Engine, so I don't really know exactly how the theme goes. I've honestly only heard it in memes. That's the only reason why I know it. Okay, let's hope this is the original. Weird, this is like a few cents out of tune. You know what's weird? Holy shit, wait a minute. Wait, this is kind of crazy, actually. Did you guys know that there's a jazz standard called Taking the A-Train? And it's got the exact same chord progression. I wonder if Thomas the Tank Engine is, like, connected to that somehow. Because, so Taking the A-Train goes like this. That's kind of wild. So that's Thomas the Tank Engine. And then Taking the A-Train. Let me see when this was written. Yeah, hold on. When was this written? This can't be a coincidence, can it? I don't know. We're this is like some conspiracy. What is happening here? Okay, when was Thomas the Tank Engine made? Origination year? I don't know what to call it. 45? Oh my god. I don't know. I think whoever made this must have been a huge fan of Taking the A-Train. Or, you know what? It probably has less to do with that. Maybe the person that made the theme songs just thought it would be a cool little Easter egg or something. Thomas the Tank Engine is a fictional anthropomorphized steam locomotive. People were really writing the craziest stories, huh? Prototype and background. Let's see if it says anything about the music. Voice actors, awards in popular culture. Wait, what? The first series of 26 stories premiered October 1984 on the ITV network in the UK with former Beatles drummer Ringo Starr as storyteller? What? Anyways, I feel like that can't be a coincidence. There's got to be a reason why they're that closely related. Because, yeah, that piece... Here, I can play it. Boom. Thank you. And then just imagine. Like, if you just swing that already, it sounds quite a bit like it. Anyways, enough of that, guys. That was just a weird little tangent. But shall we do a little bit of feedback?
Thank you for the donation. Yep.
Shezwiz, what is up, my man? Thank you for the donation. So you guys want to do some what do you guys want to do? You guys want to do feedback? Are there a lot of people here today that would like to share some music that they're working on? Where do I send demos? Well, if we're gonna do the feedback portion of the Fridays, I'll let you know how to participate. Not up with that workout. Oh yeah, wait, I'm a little bit behind. I will check Streamlabs in a moment here. Yeah, cool. Let's do it, guys. Give me a second here to get this set up. Let's see. We're not going to make it followers only. Let's make the raffle keyword exclamation mark. Moving day. And scale subblock. Sure. I think that's fair. Wait, what? Oh, wait. Oh yeah, subblock times 3. Okay, it's already in there. Sweet. I'm gonna let that let people submit if they want. So once again, if you do want to submit something for feedback Fridays, just type in exclamation mark moving day. All this like swung happy music has got me thinking about all the other related music. Yo, MCAT Scrub, thanks for subscribing. Oh, that was actually a gift from an anonymous gifter. Appreciate it, anonymous gifter. Do this. We are raffling now. Okay, Louder TV, what is up? I believe we have heard music from you before, haven't we? So, first feedback track of this Friday. Let's hit it. Rhythm of the D&B. Mm-hmm. I actually think this is pretty cool. Cool, so I actually really enjoyed the intro. I think the mix for this drop ends up suffering a bit. Let's keep listening for a sec here. This is cool. So I really like this song, man. I think you did the original justice with this idea. I think. So I kind of feel like that the rhythm of that synth at that tempo becomes a little bit like too chaotic. In comparison to, like, everything else is kind of like, that's the rhythm of the bass and the chords, kind of. And the vocals, even the vocals, even though they're sped up, like, I feel like they clash a little bit with the hecticness of that lead. Maybe if you low passed it for this section. Also, I like that like distorted sine lead thing here. I actually really liked how your drums were sounding too. But yeah, I mean, like, I think all of this is pretty damn cool. I think this section also gets a little bit confusing rhythmically. Not so much like complex in rhythm, but some of the vocal sped up sounds a little bit awkward. Yeah, the it sounds kind of like, well, there's not much you can do about it really, because that's just what it sounds like at that tempo. Yeah, this is the section that I think kind of needs the most work if you're gonna make this work, because I think honestly, I don't know, this is just my opinion, but I like what you have here quite a bit. I feel like if you built a song around that, it'd be perfectly fine. I can totally hear what you're doing here, like just kind of like leveling up the energy a bit, having some cool sound design and stuff. But I think if you're gonna do that, you may want to spend a little bit more time fine tuning a lot of the mix and the sound design, because in comparison to like a lot of this stuff here. It doesn't, I don't think it's quite up to par. Yeah, this snare is also a little strange. That one. It's not, yeah, I think, yeah, I don't really listen to that much D&B, so I don't know how much, you know, you're going to gain out of hearing my perspective on this. But, yeah, I would, I personally think that this section probably needs the most work out of what you have. And then there's this little bit here that's really cool, too. The halftime. Anyways, thanks for sharing that, man. And I hope you finish it up. Let's see. Thank you. Yeah, that's true. What I thought too, I wasn't too sure what to do. Let's see. Protostar is a bit too bland mixing wise for my personal taste. He's good though, don't get me wrong. It's funny, I spent most of my time on the last drop and then sort of spat out everything else. Yeah, Magnitude might be a good reference. Definitely helped. Thanks for the insight. Cool, man. Well, I hope you get to finish it up. Thanks for sharing. Let's roll it to the next one. Voila. Void Papers, what's up? Recognize that name? Hey, I think is it your girlfriend, your wife, one of those two? I think, or actually, was it your friend? I don't know. I'm sorry. I feel like there's multiple people that are in your life that happen to tune into my streams on occasion. I think one of them messaged me that you make some pretty cool wallpapers, and well, just art, not really wallpaper specifically. Yeah, I was checking some of them out. It's cool stuff. All right, so this is Kasar by Omnilucent. Do you listen to Tipper at all by any chance? I'd be curious if you listen to him. That makes a lot of sense. I see a lot of potential in like what you're doing compositionally with this song. If you were to take influence from like the mix down, the mixing and sound design quality that Tipper has, I think he's kind of like one of the first people that came to mind when I was listening to this, because I was thinking of other kind of like experimental downbeat electronic music that still kind of occasionally like, you know, gets some higher energy points as well. And I feel like Tipper is a really good reference for that. Yeah. So anyways, that being said, I like compositionally what you're doing here. And I think a lot of the ideas would benefit a lot by being just executed with I think like just improved sound design and mixing. And it's kind of a vague thing to say, I suppose. Hard thing to critique on as well, because obviously some of it is just kind of like your own creative decision making. But that's something that I would consider for sure, is as referencing his music, because Tipper is like a just mixing and sound design like god. He's so good at what he does, and he I think is really relevant to the style of music that you're writing. Maybe not like spot on, but close enough to reference for that kind of stuff. And I think like if you were able to incorporate the cleanliness of his mixes into like the songwriting that you have here, I think it would be even better. I hope you keep working on it, unless it's already finished. Actually, it looks like, wow, this is 7 years old. My God. I didn't even realize it's that old. That's crazy. He sent me a 7-year-old track. But anyways, thank you for sharing that, man. Appreciate it, and I hope that I hope you share more music in the future. Cool. Let's roll on to the next one. Let's do it. Wrote it in college. Nice. I like it. I am really a pancake. What's up, my friend? Awesome. So we got another track here. Let's see. This is by True AVI. Temple of Time, May version. Thank you. Sweet. It's a cool tune. So things that came to mind are, well, I think you've kind of gotten, it feels like a story, like you're telling like a story, and it has a beginning and it has an end. And I think it works as a piece, of music. I don't know why I phrased it so weirdly, but, yeah, I think this part is really cool. But one thought is, I think the snare, considering the vibe of the track, is maybe a little bit too intense. I think I was hearing something like a rim shot maybe being a little bit more relevant sonically than a snare like that, just because the snare feels like it's a bit too harsh for the sound of like the vibe that you've got here. It's like very emotional and kind of revelatory, you know. I feel like you're like coming to some kind of experiencing some kind of enlightenment or something listening to this. But yeah, I feel like the snare, it could be a snare. I just think that one in particular is maybe a bit too aggressive. So could consider doing something else there. The other thing is that right here, so the chord progression you have for this section is, so F major, G major, D minor, and then you've got the F major, G major, you've got that sus chord in there. And I feel like that's begging to have, to resolve into, well, not resolve, but lead, that would lead into the A major, I think, that's kind of what I'm hearing. Like if you had some kind of way to lead it from that suspended chord back to the F major, like the way it is right now is fine, but I think you could get a little find a nice way to lead back to the beginning of the phrase. So like what I was hearing was just something like some kind of walk. Like that, or you could do, because then you have some kind of movement that's like leading back into the beginning of the phrase, and I feel like just leaving it on that suspended chord feels like it's not that it's bad, it's, to me it sounds like you're missing a chance at adding a nice little embellishment to the progression there. But yeah. Hopefully that makes sense. I know nothing about music theory, but I will try to find that chord tomorrow. Oh yeah, no worries, man. But yeah, so essentially, instead of a typical like A major chord, which would just be A, C sharp, E, and then, you know, that's pretty much the triad. You just have like a fourth in there instead of the third. And usually when you have suspended chords, it just like, it's really satisfying to hear them resolve. But yeah, thanks for sharing that, man. Best of luck with finishing it. All right, let's roll again. Crafty Pants Pro. What is up? That is a bizarre profile picture you got there. Do pandas have tongues that long? I don't think they do. It's a lie. Why you gotta lie to me like that, bro? Okay. This is a Maddie and Be Fine remix by Cybertone. Say the world's gonna do me right. The sun rising in my head. Until I just can't believe my eyes. And you tell me it's another phase. Doesn't matter if it's real or not. I don't think I've ever had enough. Make it so the fire doesn't stop. Are you listening to me? Tell me that night. I will be fine. You can tell me that night. I will be fine. Put my So I like it. I don't know if I know the original, so kind of hard for me to know exactly what it is that you did or didn't do. But that being said, I think you can, I don't know, just knowing like Madion and the kind of production style that he has, and that Porter has, and what you've got going here, I think you can make this more impactful by having like some low end that's kind of increasing the, or helping carry like the emotional energy, because you've got the drums there, you got the chord progression going and stuff. I just think you need to fill it out a bit more, like having some big like some really big chords. This is not the sound design I would recommend necessarily, but just for reference. And then I would have some low end in there too, like a, I don't know, it could literally just be a like a distorted sub just following the chords. But yeah, anyways, thanks for sharing, man. Appreciate it. I don't really have too much to say other than that. I think it sounds cool.
Yo, we got hope you finish new it. Subscriber.
Your steams.
Yo, what's up? Thank you for subbing, Kirby. Much appreciated. What's up, Tenuous? Tenuous OCE. I wonder what that stands for. Wake up call. Incomplete. What do we got here?
Okay, hello. For the next decade, I'm okay. And all of us here are okay. Because we won't face the problems that are coming. We'll be right back.
Cool. So I've got some ideas on how you might be able to improve this. What I'm hearing for this track is kind of like this. I'm kind of hearing this jammy, melodic, mid-tempo intro. And it feels like a groove. And that leads into something that's, you know, a bit got a bit more grit, more focus on the bass line. That's generally the direction that I'm hearing with what you got so far. And I think it depends on which direction you want to take with it. I could hear, like, right now it feels a little bit like a little bit jam bandy. Like, it's kind of loose and it doesn't have too much kind of like really precise edits and that kind of stuff, which is totally fine. Like, that's a pretty specific style that you can go for with with this kind of music. And then but I could also hear, let's say specifically for this section, I think if you referenced some cone sound, you could make this a lot more interesting from like an audiophile sound design kind of perspective, because I like what you have here. Personally, I would prefer to hear, like a lot of, like, for example, like the long reverby tailed stuff to be taken out of the track and to have this part get like really dry and, much more edity and like a bunch of different kind of, maybe it's a little bit too slow to be considered mid-tempo, actually. Probably way too slow to be considered mid-tempo, but for some reason, that's how I'm hearing it. It's like slowed down mid-tempo music. But I would I think you could totally get, it's probably like more like 70 BPM or something, isn't it? Or closer to 70. Why did I think this was like mid-tempo at all? But yeah, I think you could definitely throw in some really cool sound design in between. And I would maybe to help contrast a bit more with what you have before. This is just my recommendation. You can totally ignore it. I think it'd be cool to get rid of some of those sounds. The vocal sample. That like delays, like I would get rid of the delay, for example, on that. And then there's other stuff that thing, and the clap, like all those little things, I think are steps in the right direction, like having these little additional fills and stuff. But I think even if it might not sound that great at first, it's worth trying out. Getting rid of like the reverb and the delay, and then seeing how to make those fit as like maybe fills or counter motifs to the bass line. You know, just kind of stuff like that could be really cool. Random little clicks and pops and sound design, and just get like super creative with it. But yeah, I think actually a lot of the sounds in here are already really cool. So I hope you keep working on it and finish it up. So thank you for sharing that. Much appreciated. Cheers. Cool, let's check out the next one. Anengim 5582. What's up? A YouTube link. Interesting. Is this one of your originals? Oh. Just somebody else's track, huh? Apache. It's already a while ago. Fun tune. Thank you for sharing. Anyways, let's go on to the next one. Trap Harry. Oh boy. Cool. Raphael Loper, what is up? Welcome to back to the stream. I know you've been tuned in for a hot minute now, but I wanted to say that anyways. Ooh, we got another track. What we got? Yeah. That's enough of that. Working on your tips and embracing them. Have some fun in the meantime. Cheers. Appreciate it. All right, let's roll the next one. Tomboy Squirrel, what's up? Hey, does it have to be your music if I get picked? Nope. check this out. I'm terrified. Don't be. Nothing to be afraid of. Except for every bit of criticism I could ever come up with. Alright, this is no option. Punch bootleg. I think it's a, I like the atmosphere in the track, and I like, kind of like that little, chord progression rhythm that you had going, like the, something like that. And it's kind of cool that it's a little bit of a faster tempo, maybe than some other, like, house music you might expect in this vibe. I wouldn't necessarily call this house, I'm not really sure. It might be too fast for that, but... It's kind of like garage tempo-y, isn't it? Or like drum and bass tempo. Anyways, So, I think the vocals are really far back in the mix. I think it could be nice to hear them more, even if they're meant to be kind of more atmospheric. It'd be nice to hear and be able to, like, just tell what's being said a bit more clearly. So that's one suggestion I have. And then... It sounds like there's some frequency clashes happening in the low end. Like, that downbeat sounds like there's, like, some clipping happening there or something. I might want to double check and make sure that you're, like, side-chaining the right frequencies for the right elements. So that's another suggestion I got. I'm kind of curious. I wonder what the idea would sound like if you did something more along the lines of either if you did it slower, like, or if you're doing it at that tempo, maybe try to, I don't know, shuffle the beat a little bit more. It's very kind of like static and dry, which I think works a little bit better when it's at a house tempo. But I think if you're gonna go that fast, maybe spice up the rhythm a little bit more. Like, add a nice, like that kind of thing in there, maybe. Or like also a fill going into the downbeat could be kind of cool. Maybe everything gets kind of dry for a second, and gets kind of like, sucked up into a vacuum, and then you just hear this, like, this tight little drum fill, and it goes into, like, the vibe you got here. So there's a couple ideas to work with. I do think you can improve the mix a bit, making sure that you're side-chaining the proper elements. Yeah. yeah, it's a cool track. It's got an interesting vibe. If you skip forward, it changes. I can go forward a little bit. Like I'm at like a. It's kind of like bossa nova tempo. But yeah, it's a cool tune. Thanks for sharing, man. Or bootleg, I suppose. Sorry. Noodle dance. Yeah. But yeah, Tomboy Squirrel, thanks for sharing that. And that's pretty much the only advice I have for that. I'd like to hear... the style you're going for with some like more in-depth execution. I think just going more into detail on as many aspects as you can, you know, trying to add like little flourishes and embellishments and making sure that every single thing that you want in the music is there. You know, if there's something slightly off, like I would say clipping is not something you usually want in a track. So finding out what's causing that and getting rid of that, things like little details like that will help you so much in making sure that people understand what you're going for. So yeah. Anyways, thanks for showing that, man. Let's roll on to the next one. Neil G. Are you Neil OG? Are you the original Neil, the first Neil, the one Neil to rule them all? All right, let's check out what you got, Neil. No, thanks. It's nice. I really like the idea. Hold on. I think there's room for, first of all, I think once you do kind of, you know, put like 30 OGTs on your master, it's going to sound a lot better. And by that, I'm just jokingly saying, you know, once you limit this a bit more, I think it'll naturally make things sound a bit fuller, which will be nice. But the mix is good. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying anything about the mix. I think the mix is good. And I like a lot of the sound design that you've done here. I think the chords in the beginning, like the vocal sample and all that, I think it's great. yeah, so I think that's all cool. I do think you have room for creating like more edits on top of what you've got here. And by that I mean just things to take what I would consider a good track to like a great track. And I think what you've got here is a like a well executed I would consider it like an EDM track. And I think it's well done. But I think for you to take it to I hate it when people say this. I don't know why, but let me try to find a better way to phrase it. To make it more unique, I think you should go even more into detail on some of these things on the track. So, here, for example, you got a really big opportunity to do some stuff. So obviously the silence is kind of important because you're trying to draw attention to what's about to happen. But there are small things that you can do. You consider adding like a subtle fill. You could, I hear maybe like reverse reverb from the kick drum, like almost like a rumble that's like something that's like in the low end, like a stampede or something, like just that's leading you into that downbeat, like the downbeat though is a fake out, right? So so I think that fake out, I think you for sure can make that crazier. So and then boom, like do something rhythmic there. And the laser thing that you have going in the background is great, but I think if you do something like, because it's very static, the beat is like boom boom boom, like hits hard, and I think that's the kind of moment where you can get away with like having a little like flair, like a rhythmic flair. And then you could do the same thing at the end of the phrasing for this. So the second measure of the drop, at the end of that second measure. So I'll try to beatbox what you have right now. So it's. Something like that, right? So I think what you could do is you could have like. And then just add like little stuff like that, little pops and clicks and fills, and just make it even more exciting, I guess. Because what you have is really good. I think you can make it amazing. You're not terrible at mixing at all. This is good. But yeah, thanks for showing that, Neil. Okay, it is 7 o'clock, so I was gonna end the stream here, to finish up packing and get other stuff out of the way before I move tomorrow. But let's do one more. I skipped out on Wednesday and I kind of feel bad for that, so let's do at least one more here. And I always feel bad that like I don't like the thought that there are people that come and join the stream and are waiting around to see if they can get like critique on their track, and then for them never to be in the get the raffle. But there's just no other system that I feel like makes sense. I feel like it has to be like randomly chosen. I can't just kind of like pick out people myself or something. So let's roll it one more time here, and then we'll call it. DOXI. Hey, thank you.
Just wanted to let you know I've inside your paintings after ruining 2 of them.
Ruining? I find it hard to believe that you have the capacity to ruin a painting, but I'm super excited. Yeah. I'm definitely gonna post a photo of that in the Discord once I get it hung up in the apartment. I'm excited. Oh, hey yo, what's up, Dio? Voicians, thanks for rating. This is a song I like that I would like you to play. Sounds like a simple request. What's up? Yo, Maximum, thank you for gifting that sub to Sandhope. Song. Anyways, that's my first impression listening to it, jamming over it thing. Hope you enjoyed that. It's a great piece. Thanks for sharing that. Yeah, let me like this. Save.
Yo, we got a
new subscriber.
Wait, did I miss a sub earlier? I don't think so, right? Sly Xera, thank you for the sub. Okay, let's switch accounts. Yeah. All right, guys. Well, appreciate you hanging out and showing me cool music. This is awesome. It was really fun listening to all the tracks for feedback, and I also like it equally as much when people just share music they like too. I always love hearing stuff that I never would have heard of otherwise. But yeah, that's gonna be it for today, unfortunately. Me and Alphonse got some more work to do. I'm gonna wear this super extra jacket right now before I say bye. All right. Well, next time I stream, I will be in a new apartment, so that's super exciting. And I will also have some new emotes next week, so that's something to look forward to. But yeah. You guys take care. Enjoy your weekend. Thank you so much for tuning in. Rip, I just joined. Keshav, thank you for the cheer. All good, man. I'll be back next week. And the streaming schedule was a little bit out of whack because of getting ready for this move. But I want to be investing a lot of time into this, and obviously having a lot of fun with it. I feel like there's a lot of potential for me to get creative in the Twitch streaming world. A lot of things that I haven't really tapped into yet. But yeah, thank you guys for hanging out, and I hope you're as excited as I am for the upcoming streams. So yeah, thanks for tuning in. Take care. Stay fresh. Drink water. All that good stuff. I'll see you guys next week. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.